Somewhere in the Rocky Mountains, I was approached by a British gentleman. A casual at that.
Alright, it's Chevin Bong! Chevin fucking Bong!
What the fuck do you want?
I heard you doing a series!
No, that's for casuals. But I know someone who is.
Oi, can you give me his name?
No.
Alright, you're such a fucking fag!
No, I only smoke fags, thank you. No homo.
Fuck it.
Hey guys, what's going on? Beatstar here, and we are starting a new Let's Play series for Hitman Blood Money. We're gonna be playing this game to tie us off until, you know, Max Payne 3 comes out, and then we're gonna be playing that. Oh boy! Fun cutscene. Let's skip it. So apparently we're targeting a Joseph Clarence, who is the proprietor of a carnival, or some shit like that. And then, in which, we have to go assassinate him, obviously. But we have to also go through a bunch of other shit, because this is a tutorial level.
This training level will introduce to you...
I don't give a fuck, let's do this. You! Now, look at the person you play as. This is Agent 47, a man known not to give any fucks. He has barcode on the top of his head, even though the numbers aren't there. They were in the previous games, but I'm guessing they just did it because it's for casuals.
Welcome to the States, 47.
You get this nice, womanly voice that you have to listen to, no matter what.
Locate the owner and take him out. The target is a Joseph Clarence.
Apparently I don't exist.
Our client made a special request. That the photograph you have in your possession be the last thing the target sees.
Cool.
Mr. Clarence has somehow become involved with a narcotics distribution ring, so yeah. The park may still have some
now you see me.
Enjoy the ride, 47.
Conveniently starting at the end of her conversation, so I approach this guy, and it's gonna be like,
what the fuck you looking at, Kraken?
Your ugly ass face, bitch!
Clarence.
Come over here. Punk ass motherfucker! That's right, you don't fuck with me. I'm a trill nigga. I'm blacker than you are, bitch. Now look at that sense of self-accomplishment. You're not gonna get that in any other game. So let's go into the store. Nice and decrepit, if I even know what that word means. You get out one of your little gay ass coins. And you throw it over here. Now they're gonna be like, what the fuck was that? Oh my god, you dude, god, I'm gonna go punch you out now. Bitch ass nigga. Punk this bitch. Ah, he shot me, but I can't even fight back. There we go. Wow. Fucking gay as shit. So once you do that, you are pretty much good for this area. You have to move up to the next one, which has another guy over there. So let's do that right now. You see this guy? He's trying to interrogate a lawyer from the South, I think.
That's good. It doesn't sound sincere, but it's good. Because you're about to be purified, motherfucker.
Purified.
The fire gonna burn the grime and the filth and the sin off your body and soul till ain't nothing left. But the holy fear of God in your heart.
I swear to God.
Hey, casual, right behind you.
Damn straight.
Help me! Help! Help me!
No. Now, even though you might consider that a very douchebag move, you're not going to be able to help that guy out in any way. You're practically just either to leave him there, shoot him in the face, or blow him up with the propane tank or gas tank, whatever the fuck it is. Now we have to go to the next room. This is actually a developer of the game who made this little prop right here. Obviously. Fuck! Bitch ass niggas. Didn't even see what was coming. Now you grab these guys, put them in the little freezers. That's one. Once you grab the other, that makes two. Now what you need to do, and this is imperative, guys, you need to do this, and you have to do this. Wait for him to come inside, because if he sees you, he'll just hide there for the rest of the level, and you don't want to do that. So, now that that's over with, we have one or two options. You can point at this guy.
No help in here, guys.
Yo, hold up.
Get the key card. Grab him. We can either anally rape him right here, or... Nah, let's do that. Bitch-ass nuke. Get all the stuff you need. Use the key card. Maybe move him back a little bit so the guards don't see him. And swipe yourself in. He shouldn't be able to see the corpse, so your cover should be pretty well off. Now, what you have to do now is go over here. See the gun? Grab that gun, and you put it in the baking soda crate. Now, you have to pick this thing up first, I understand. Apparently, I don't know shit. Just do that. Now that the gun's in there, you can pick it up for yourself and make it to the next guard. Now, he's gonna be like, I gotta scan you, white boy.
Gotta check you, white bread.
Yep. Whatever, do your fucking work. He's like, alright, you cool.
Alright, you cool.
I knew it. Now that you've done that, you are free to do whatever you want without any fear of consequences.
I can get the money, sweet.
Another gay-ass fucking cutscene I don't want to watch. This guy's going to be freaking himself out. Well, we don't have time for that menial shit. What we have to do now is sneak ourselves down, give him a little bit of a Brooklyn strangle, if you know what I mean. Now we're gonna go to Boston, because that's where we represent, yeah? Now let's go cut out the power supply. You grab this, you mess with the wires, and you take it out. Now you gotta get the gun out and shoot everyone, because we don't like them. What the fuck? And you can stay, because you did your purpose. Since he wasn't fucking useless, I didn't have to kill him, so I didn't. Now there's going to be a guy pissing, and apparently he had no knowledge of the event whatsoever. So you grab the other gun. Maybe surprise him a little bit.
Like they say, the longer they come, the longer they piss.
Okay. Fucking useless. Let's make our way upstairs. There's gonna be three guys you're gonna have to snipe from up here. One's gonna be on top of a Ferris wheel. Don't care about that cutscene, bro. One's gonna be on top of a Ferris wheel, as I said, or in the middle. One's gonna be on top of a building, and one's gonna be cleaning the streets, so to speak. You can't hold your breath in this game, so you just gotta shoot him in the face and hope you don't miss. Next guy should be right over. Oh, where is that fucker? Well, here's another. Now, the last one should be over here. I'm just trying to find the guy. Shit. Oh, there he is. That's all three. You don't need this gun anymore, but if you like it, you can bring it with you. I think it's a one-hit kill. You'll lose some health over there if you don't take the little gay-ass rail. But, you know, since I'm not a faggot, I don't take it. You go up here. You can either use a syringe to kill the guy off, or you can go the way, way better way. And that's, throwing one over there.
What the fuck?
No! You're not gonna kill me yet, bitch! Bitch ass nigga. And what are you doing down there? Fuck you, bitch. Now, she'll instantly stop once you're good enough distance. You'll be able to do that. Now, you want to see that in slow motion? Let's do that. Yeah, I like that, Grucious scene. Now, let's go over and kill, the last guy, which is the guy with a Boston accent.
Who the hell are you? How'd you get in here? Carol Ann!
Carol Ann's dead.
My client has hired me to show you this
photograph.
I don't understand.
My client does not like casuals, you fucking faggot. Please. Some drinks and... Oh my god, what the fuck am I saying? Drink some fucking double dew, bitch ass nigga.
You can't throw things at him. That doesn't do damage.
I'm responsible for? I can't sleep. I haven't slept in... the guilt I feel.
Now, what is he gonna say?
I'm so sorry. I know I can never...
Shut the fuck up. Just stand and die. How hard is that, really? Now, you can't hit him any... Oh, yeah, you can. Apparently, it'll only hit his head. And you can't chop off any bones, which is also unfortunate. But you can still move on to the next place. Just grab the last things you'll need to make your nice exit. And we'll conclude this level with a nice finish. Now another guy's gonna pop up and say something.
Come on, bitch. We got an intruder scoop. Some motherfucker busted in on Jay-Z's watch.
You know, I don't like uninvited guests. I'm gonna bust a cap in his ass.
Jay-Z is my nigga. Have you ever heard the song Niggas in Paris? That shit's awesome.
It was my orders that caused the problem. Is that what you're trying to say?
Nah, Scoops, I ain't say that shit.
I'd like to give you a lesson in personal responsibility.
Sorry.
Hey, Jay, but seeing as there's an intruder on the premises, I'm a little pressed for time. So I'm afraid you'll have to be a lesson in personal responsibility.
He's gonna pull out the gun. Now watch this. I like how he just chills. Wait, this guy has a gun. What is he doing? Oh, fuck. Okay, I got a plan. This time it should work. And everything worked out better than expected. Now, you might be thinking, shoot the lady, right? No. I'm not that nice. I gotta Chris Brown this hoe. It's Chris Brown. Haha, Rihanna. I can transform you. Okay. Now, let's make the scene look semi-believable. This guy was drunk. This guy is like a cannibal and ate the other guy's head. And Scoop Dog over here, he was the culprit. He shot himself in the head. There we go. I will never be indicted because I'm behind 7 proxies. Fuck you guys. I'm out of here. Yeah, the Range Slayer. I like that title. Now, apparently I'm a silent assassin now. You mad? Yeah, he's mad.
Hello, 47. Your next target's in Chile. His name is Fernando Delgado. Used to be a colonel in Pinochet's intelligence service. Now he's running a cocaine factory under cover of a vineyard. Satellite imaging suggests the lab is underground. Fernando's son, Manuel, is on the coke trade. So to make it look like a drug hit, you'll have to take him out too. We'll get you in with a pensioner's club from Santiago.
Es un hombre maravilloso.
Hermano.
Thank you.
What the fuck do you want from me this time, Diana?
Hello, 47. We've got some business at the Paris Opera. There are two targets, the famous tenor and Richard Della Hunt, the American ambassador to the Vatican.
Sounds like a faggot.
Our client claims they're behind a prostitution ring trafficking in boys and girls from Eastern Europe.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Tosca is still in rehearsal, so there's plenty of activity at the opera house and you shouldn't be too conspicuous. Ambassador Della Hunt watches most rehearsals from his box. He travels with an armed escort, but there shouldn't be any other security to speak of. You'll get some cover from the construction crews renovating the theater for the new season. We've also left you a pickup in the cloakroom.
Nice.
In the third act of Tosca, the tenor faces a firing squad. That scene may provide a useful opportunity. It's a straightforward assignment, 47, but the agency's been having some problems in Paris. Use extreme caution.
Okay, let's do this.
Now, before you say, who is this ugly-looking motherfucker, I'll give you a chance to look at the face of this guy. Yeah, he's not much to look at. That said, let's get on with the mission, and less about the character I made in Photoshop 2 years ago in 20 minutes. God, you're one ugly-looking motherfucker. Like a somebody! I think I made it on an inspiration from Buck Lau or something like that. But now that I moved past that mentality of having an Asian character to play instead of a Caucasian one. We're gonna have butt sex over here. Let's turn off the light. Bring this character in. Have fun. Now, before they see anything a little bit suspicious, I'm hoping that the free time I have, I can use to the full efficiency of possibility. Whatever the fuck I was saying. Now, we're gonna try doing this game without raising any alarms, unlike the previous two missions. We're gonna try doing this on the down low. Hopefully not attracting the attention of any motherfucker. And you can do this by throwing coins at people. Once this character gets out. And there's another tip too. If you want to slow down the play, or stop the rehearsal, this is a really neat trick. It really throws them off and they don't even get mad at you for it. See? Instantly stop the play. Now I have about 2 more minutes before the play starts again to do whatever the fuck I want. Meantime, throw the coin over here. Make him look that way. And I slip by undetected down here. He didn't even know. Such is the idiocy of people who play this game. Such as myself. But we're gonna look at this guy over here. Wait till he does absolutely nothing or turns back. That guy who took a piss just got down. He's grabbing some power tools. Now, while they're busy doing body work, we should introduce ourselves, shall we? First, let them do the turn. He's probably gonna stick to this schedule. In the meantime, now he's done. See, they didn't even notice us right over here. Now that we're safe, can leave our suitcase right over here, or unpack it, rather, and use it when the time is right. We can wait till roll call, or we could just keep it right over here. Now, while that is taking its course, we'll make our way back down. Hopefully, he didn't notice me. If he does, I'll have to punch him out. Roll call. Good. Let me get detected over there. While we may remain mindful of everyone else in the back, we introduce ourselves, go up here. There might be a guy who's lifting a crate. Be sure to be mindful of that guy. Then there's the stage actors. This is the stage actor side. The keyhole. Sure there's no guys on either side. And walk up to set our second trap. This guy's probably gonna be like, hell nah. Let's show him the way up and then knock his fucking face in. Hopefully they don't notice me under here. Nah, they shouldn't, right? Ah. That better not be the case. I want him to be bogus as shit. If we're sending cops, I'm gonna be mad. The play is going as expected, which is good. They're bringing a copper up right now, I think. Nope, that's just the escort. These are the two guys that are watching the shift. Maybe they're going up. I'm not sure. This is the basement place anyway. These are them moving up. Oh, wait. We should be clear. We'll make our way up, plant the bomb, and then wait for our plans to fall into play. Now, if we push him off here, it will not cancel the play. But we're going to try doing something a little bit more sneaky. That's a do it Brooklyn style.
Fetchkitty, s'il vous plaît.
Tieni a mente al primo colpo, giù. Ne rialzarti innanzi ch'io ti chiami.
If another one of those motherfuckers come up, we're screwed. So. Oh, fuck. Crap. They see us. But the play isn't canceled. You know what that means? Keep on going with the plan. Be careful, our eyes mindful, though. Cops are coming by the second. We're making our way out. Quick escape. Oh shit. Fuck. Well, there goes one. My plan failed miserably. There goes two. Now, there's only one fucking way out of this bitch. Let's create a distraction while we still have time. Once we get up here. That shit. Oh, fuck. Well, so much for not activating an alarm. Keep your eyes mindful of the people that are coming down the stairs. Make sure not to trip over them or any shit like that. Oh, fuck. The fuck you think you're doing, punk? You too. I ain't done with this gun, bitch. We're going for a ride. As soon as I can't use him as a hostage. Well, he has to die from a hemorrhage or some shit. What do you think I'm doing? Going out in style, bitch. Now that we have all the props out here, nice and disoriented, we can make our leave. That's by confusing the shit out of these guys, while running away like a little bitch. Come on. Damn door. Made our nice little escape, with our character looking slightly different. Well, that's it for this level. You see the cop cocked his gun? Probably gonna shoot me in the back of the head for killing all of his buddies. Well, that looks like it's about it. Thanks for watching. Look at all those stats, motherfucker. Yeah. Deranged Slayer. I got that rating once again. Now that's what I'm talking about. I like it.
And that's how I lost my dick.
Damn, son.
One second, I gotta get this. It's you.
It's good to have you back, 47. I'm glad to hear you're fully recovered.
Thanks, I guess.
Your next assignment's in Northern California.
The casuals.
Three mobsters have been checked into a rehab clinic for alcoholics. One of them plans to turn state's witness as soon as he's discharged. Our client wants to avoid that, but we don't know which of the three is the target.
I can see why.
An undercover agent placed at the clinic to find out hasn't been heard from in a few days.
Too bad for him.
The clinic will only discharge patients if they're sober or dead.
Oh.
The agent who's in there is apparently being kept drunk for unknown reasons. So you'll have to kill him to get him out, but we need him alive. We're giving you an experimental serum that'll give him the appearance of being dead, along with the antidote to bring him back once you're out. Something's very wrong at this clinic, 47. Keep your eyes open.
How should I start off the episode?
They tried to make me go to rehab, I said no, no, no.
No, I can't put that song in there. UMG's gonna sue my ass off if I do. Shit. How about this?
It's the motherfucking Eagle Double G.
Snoop Dogg!
What?
Smoke weed every day.
With that in mind, I'm playing part 4 of our Let's Play for Hitman Blood Money. Let's do this. So we are going to rehab, of course. There's the mobster on the what's it called again? Point of view or some shit like that. Person, what the fuck? I'm not even gonna try. So this is a fucking guard over here. We're gonna wait for him to go around the fucking thing so we can get one of the tickets from this guy.
Damn busybodies, they think they know everything. I never want to leave this place.
Now he's gonna look like this, right? He's smoking over here. If I take this thing, he's gonna start shooting. Watch. Oh. Nice. Now, once you take that item, you notice the heavenly music is going on. That's kind of creepy, but I don't really give a fuck. He says he never wants to leave the place, right? He's busy smoking on a cigarette, doing nothing at all, and he's not even going to notice that it's gone, which is the most surprising thing of all these other things. So, yep. Sup? Oh, I got to place the admission paper. Get changed in, right?
Welcome. You'll be staying in room A. Just step into the dressing room, change into a robe, and leave your clothes and personal effects for safekeeping.
Sounds about legit. Now, we have to do exactly that. Hopefully she doesn't creepily follow me in there. You're not opening the door like that. That's fucking weird. So, put this stuff in here. You might... should I keep the gun in here? let's take that risk. If all we're going to be able to bring in here is a fucking sniper, that's going to suck. But I am now patient. We're going to do this shit. Oh, wait. I need to bring my suitcase. I don't go anywhere without my suitcase.
Gonna have to search you, sir.
Okay. Do it fast, though. Don't pat my balls. Oh, shit. My bad.
You ain't getting past me with a weapon, fella.
Hey, I have a weapon on me? Let me double check. Oh, yeah, that's right. These mines do pop up. Fuck. Guess I have to leave them here. That means if one of them find it, I will be good. I think putting it right there should be fine. Let's try again.
Gonna have to search you, sir.
Go ahead. I better not have that mine on me, otherwise I'm gonna be pissed. Ah, shit.
I already told you, big guy. No heat gets past me.
Alright. I better make sure. Huh. You're a Rack 47. What have you done to get into this fucking hellhole? Let's try this one final time. What am I bringing in the building that's making this stuff go off? The syringes shouldn't pop up. I think we'll have to leave this in here. So, when we go around, we're gonna be carrying an empty rifle case. Pick up the rifle case. Maybe a silver baller. Hopefully this goes in here. Ah, shit, it doesn't. Well, let's try one last time. Don't. Good.
Thanks. You're all set.
Thank God. Now, apparently we're gonna have to find the inmates. They're very good at distinguishing these people. You can actually notice if this is the guy, this is the guy. And the other one's pink and the other one's blue, I think.
You seen the shrink? I usually get my session about now.
Thank you for telling me out in the open. Because if I'm gonna kill you, might as well make it easy, right? Right. Shit. So, you gotta go around. Hopefully find a nice place for us to be. Like a PIMP. I think this is the shrink's office, so might as well loiter around here. Maybe see if the shrink is around. Like, really. Picking this lock. Don't give a fuck. Nothing in here, though. Another lock to pick. This is another one of his studies. Third one should be around here. Nothing important whatsoever. It's making my job practically fucking pointless. Where's this son of a bitch? Oh, yeah, that's right. Already went here before. Go around here. If he's gonna drink out of that thing again, we might as well poison it, so. He can be punished for his sins. Drinking in rehab? Really? Are you Amy Winehouse or some shit? Ba-dum-ps. Now, here's what we're gonna do to make it extra, extra cool. Pick up the rifle case. Get the fuck out of here. And just continue on our way. This is the guard office, obviously. One of them is gonna repop up and go around here. I've never actually done this mission without setting off the alarm, so if I'm able to do so, it will be a personal achievement. Now we have all our guns. We can get the fuck out again. Now we won't even have to worry about getting any guns or not having any guns. Save the game. Once that's successful, just go around searching around the building, trying to find yourself in the social epitome, which is the fucking basement. Now, it is to my understanding that there's guards every fucking where down here, so we gotta be careful not to alarm any of them. Shit, we already saved. Nothing scarier than going around in this fucking thing. Ugh. Hopefully no one notices me ever doing this. Ever. Oh, fuck!
Get out of here, buddy, or there's gonna be trouble.
Suck my dick! Shit! Fuck! You bitch! Urgh. Fuck, 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 fuck! Oh, he sees me, doesn't he? Shit. Oh, fuck. I'm not even invincible. Oh, he's getting back up, though, and doing a weird-ass pose.
Hey, you got no business here.
Ah, fuck. What? You morphed into the... How are you morphing into the fucking wall? You too, bitch. Fuck. We got all these fucking rats on us. We're getting the fuck out of here. That's what we know for sure. Got a bullet stain in my fucking ass. Shit. So apparently the game fucking crashed in the middle of the thing. God damn. I'm pissed. And quite frankly, who can blame me? Shit. The game crashed right in front of my face. I wasn't crying, I was burping, by the way. But shit. For real? We're not gonna leave this guy over here, by the way. Even if someone's coming over soon enough. Come on. I don't have time for this shit. Nope, you're staying asleep, bro. He is gonna come by soon enough, though. I know that for sure. Huh. We'll keep this guy away. Cause he's a bitch, nigga. That. My fucking game crashed. It was the best fucking footage I had. Well, you'd have to trust it on this game for it to, you know, like, ruin that moment. Oh well. Now we're gonna try and dump this guy over somewhere. We just gotta find a place. I think this should be good. Yeah, it should. No witnesses. Can't pick up a second stun gun, apparently. None of these guys notice, so that's good, too. Let's go around the lower way. Hopefully none of them recognize me, because if they do, that's going to suck. This guy's, like, spazzing out. I think he will see me, though. What is he going to do? He does recognize me, but he's not suspicious of shit. Thank God. We're going to go around, hope for the best, and get the hell out of here. They're moving him out of the morgue right now. And the guy we killed all the way back here, he was turned out to be our main target, so we don't have to kill anybody extra. But we could if we wanted to. So that's what we're gonna do, mainly. So, let's just inconspicuously look over here. Being a part of the clerical staff, I'm surprised none of them are looking at me any suspiciously or anything like that. Here's him and his bodyguard. We'll waste them both once they get into the gay-ass hot tub. Go ahead. You know you want some.
I want hot tub time. I want hot tub time.
You know you want it too.
You seen the shrink?
I usually get my session about now.
He's gonna kill me!
No, I'm not. You're just dead. I don't like you. So, have a nice day. Hopefully they don't... Oh, shit. How's this gonna work out? Get out of the fucking water. Go into this tub. Shit. I had to do everything around this fucking clinic. That's what you get for being an employee here. There's no benefits, no 401k. We had to deal with this fucker right over here. God damn, you're a fucking ugly piece of shit. I need a drink. He drowned. I did absolutely nothing to save him. I hope you feel happy for yourself, you little bitch.
Don't do anything stupid, pal.
You're not going anywhere.
Shit. I'm gonna just hide here. Oh, fuck! In here we go. In here we are going.
No one has to get hurt here.
How did they not notice me? Holy crap, I'm invincible. You go to sleep. And you should too. This guy's a dead witness. Hopefully we lead him off. This trail of blood. Come on, get in the fucking pool, you. You know you wanna. Die.
You see what happened?
I had no part in this, gentlemen. He's just dead. Narrowly dodged that bullet now, didn't I? This guy's suspicious. If he pulls out his gun, I'll have time to disarm him. Thank God he's not suspicious of me. But how are we gonna do this? We can go around. Take that little route. Pick the lock over here. I was not caught on camera. That's bullshit, nigga. You look at the camera yourself. You're not seeing anything. So... you suspicious, I punch you in the fucking face. Your choice. Good. Now that to see the little witness tampering over there. Is this our guy? No, it's just another security guard or a shrink. Crap. Out of all the times you don't tour this place. Oh fuck! Shit! Well, it looks like they fucking see me. Remember this guy? Yep, he was the one I knocked out earlier.
I'm invincible.
Well, disregarding that, I'm getting out of here. I'm not coming back. I'll have you guys know.
Don't nobody do.
I was caught on camera. How the fuck? No witnesses. Bitch. Fuck. How do I get over here? Hey, pretty lady. You want your jimmies to be rustled? Huh? Huh?
Oh god, oh god, oh god!
Bitch ass motherfucker. You're trying to punch me. You're wasting your time, as well as mine. All I have to do now is get the hell out of here and never fucking come back. They communicate by radio, so I can't maintain any eye contact whatsoever with these guys, else I'd be shot at and killed. If they see me, I gotta be the one who shoots first. Good, they don't see me. Go down in a zigzag pattern. Hopefully they won't even notice. He's a little bit suspicious, but I hopefully doesn't give a shit. He's coming back. Fuck. Hide here and twirl. That's what I told myself.
I got a surprise for you, buddy. That's what you get when you fuck with the trill, nigga. I'd kill you, but my silencer's in the other building. Rise and shine, motherfucker. Now wake up. You have much living to do. Yeah, that's right. We're bringing him along too, for some fun times. Let's go, man. Looks like that's about it.
And that's the end of this session. Even though the thing fucking blanked out and froze my game, I don't care. I won, bitch. Now look at all that. I'm a mad butcher now. Hell yeah. Thanks for watching. Look at me, Slay 12. Let's see what they say about me. Four innocent patients. Four security professionals. No shit. 22 shots. I'm a talented marksman. That's nice. And I used a cop gun. Thank God. I'm pretty happy with myself. This is a achievement, if anything. So, thanks for watching. I'm out. Peace.
Hey guys, what's going on? Beatstar here, and we are playing Hitman Blood Money, Part 5, A New Life. Now, I know you're expecting a very, very long and boring and increasingly edited video of me explaining the entire synopsis of the mission, but I'll pass on that. You get to watch this Gaye cutscene, and then this one, and then...
We're sending you down to the other end of the state, 47.
God damn it.
The target's a gangster by the name of Vinny Sinistra. He's in a witness protection program pending a court appearance later this month. Our client wants to be sure Sinistra doesn't make it to the witness box. Sinistra's also got some hard evidence that can't be allowed to see the light of day. Our client thinks it may be on a bit of microfilm. Ensure that you retrieve it. Sinistra is extremely unstable and hasn't taken well to suburban life. They're having a birthday party for the youngest child on Sunday, and this may give you the angle you need to get in. The house is being monitored and protected by the feds, so extreme discretion is required. Tread lightly, 47.
Okay, let's get our mission on the road. Yeah. Now, there's a jogger over here. Our goal is to kill the Vinny Slugger Sinistra. Yeah, good nickname there, buddy. And yes, I stole that from a Beato.
Great pace, but are you really comfortable in those clothes?
Yes, don't judge me, jerk. So what we're gonna do is just, go over here, do the good old steal this trick from a Beato again. Get over here. Put this in the donuts. Inject it into the air, what the fuck. And then knock it, and then get the hell out of there. While all this other stuff is happening, go get your briefcase, and then go to the next place. Which is gonna be over here, getting the other guy. See, that garbage man is connected to this garbage man, and he's gonna come back and forth there and back a few times. What we need to do is make sure once the jogger goes around, we get him, we shoot him in the head, and we have our fun. So there he is. Once we have our good distance, grab the gun. Pop him out a little bit. See this bitch? Yeah, you know where he's going. Oh shit. You gotta get in there. Now let's see if, oh fuck. Oh. Fuck. Well, might as well make that round while we still have time. Son of a bitch. Once he runs over here,
are going to knock him out and put him into the garbage disposal. Hi. He's gonna run, see the blood. Look at me suspiciously, whatever. Let's try not doing this with pick him up. That guy's gone isn't gonna come back. Let's make our rounds. This guy first, because the other guy will carry our disguise. We got a bit of time before the next one comes. Let's go.
Damn casuals. Why do they weigh so much?
Grab his clothes. Put him in there. Now, it's not gonna be suspicious at all that there's a trail of blood and then this fucking suit over here. Well, hopefully not anyways. Or the garbage bag for that matter. So once the jogger goes around, he's gonna go get the popo and then they're gonna get a little bit pissy that I'm the only garbage man in the neighborhood. And the other one just mysteriously disappeared. Now that I'm the garbage man, though, what I can do is go over here and freely go as I please. What we're gonna get here is this whole thing, which is ether. It is a sedative that can be used to knock out dogs, as I'm sure you know.
Behind my back, but in my face, shots of well wishes, friendly acting, envy, hot and snakes.
There for no particular reason. Get the darts. And I'll introduce you to a nice surprise over there. I'm not talking about this chick over here checking the whatever. Yeah, doing her little hedge. No, I'm talking about a bullet over there. We're gonna be the garbage man, hopefully be able to go into this nice little secluded treehouse.
And you won't even say anything.
Hey, where is the guy who does the jogging? Oh yeah, that's right, I killed him. Let me just give an honorable death to the guy. Oh, there is nothing. Hopefully I don't get the you're not supposed to be here bullshit. Cause you know I am. Great. Grab the gun. And you know what we're gonna do? Wrong, we're not gonna shoot him. We go down here and shoot the lady first. We got 12 bullets up in this bitch. So. You gun down here. Hopefully the whole neighborhood isn't on us yet. Great. Oh. Good. And remember, there is no more patrolling people that are going around here since we killed the guy who was jogging, the garbage man, and the other garbage man. So, it's just this fucking hag. Thankfully, she didn't mind. Marvelous. Grab the air rifle. And we're gonna make our second round. Next time on Good Old Fido. Time to Michael Vick your ass, you son of a... Oh, you are a bitch. But you won't be able to see me. Because thankfully, that is out of the picture. These guys aren't suspicious. So we're good. And we can go freely around this place over here without any other suspicions. Hopefully that is. Because I don't want to see the guards coming over me and confronting me and all that bullshit. So let's save the game just in case. And go in the secret stealth mission way. Whatever way that is. Thank you. Now, I know you might be wondering, hey, man, there's a fucking camera right there. And you would be right.
No shit, Sherlock.
That's why I'm going in like a boss, looking at the camera before I shoot it.
Are you fucking kidding me? Fuck!
There you go. The dog doesn't have to die. That's fucking disgusting. And there is a secret agent down here. So if he sees me, I'm fucked. Might as well make my time here enjoyable, though. Since he does come downstairs. This is it, 47. Save the game right now. This is when we're gonna come in and fucking sneak up the ass. Don't look this way, come on.
Get lost, Chumley.
You're calling me Chumley? Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Chumley? Is that the best you can do, you fucking queer? God damn, this place is full of casuals. Well, now that I'm confident I can never return to that area, I'll just have to stay here, posted on the block, like a black guy. Now that we've made our rounds around that neighborhood and killed a cop down there, we best not do any more excessive killing. Any gratuitous murder and we'd be in deep shit. So, steal the videotape, grab a little bit more pistols, you'll never know if you need them, and make your rounds. Because that's my favorite, most homosexual phrase now. Anyways, now that you took the videotape, you will no longer be able to be recorded on camera, which is a good thing, but yeah. Let this guy open a door for you. He's not suspicious of us because we're not in our same uniform. Or, outfit. So we catch the wife. We can't pick the lock. We're gonna go take the other way. Just this way. We're gonna wait for this guy to go over here. We'll kill him the old fashioned way. Piano wire. Whatever. Oh my god. We're gonna try something different. And this is using the third save, so it's all or nothing in here. I love carrying around coins, so let's try using that.
Yeah, that's right. You did see a coin.
We'll just gate him around here. Oh, he saw me doing that. That's not as cool. Just, you'll know. There we go.
Wonder what that was.
It's a coin.
That I moved over there.
No one has to get hurt here.
The fucking wife didn't even see. Wow. Well, all I have to do is move him over here now. He's the next target in this wonderful contraption I've made. That way no one will ever know he's even here. Because if I killed the guy, he'd just add another murder. So knocking him out would be good too. Plus no one ever goes there, so I'll be doubly good. Let's wait for this very gay pool boy to get over here. Got our third, no, it's not the third, it's the second. Wait for this guy. He's gonna come around. You can do that. He'll lay that down there. hopefully he doesn't notice you doing this. Once he goes in, which should be any minute now, you'll be able to make your move. Come on. String, you fucking wire, you! Of all the people, you have to be the most worthless. Whatever. Alright, make me the pool boy now. Wait, you're dead. I killed you. There you go. Now you can take his, skin. Now you're this fancy, well-dressed man. Go and, hit on the wife.
The pool isn't the only thing I need serviced.
That's not funny, you faggot. I already used that.
Come on.
No, I mean, oh my god. Why, Adios Entertainment? Why? I don't want to jump in a lake, face down, and never come back up. Is that too much to ask? Don't worry, it's just my way, lady. Come on. I wonder if they'll ask me if I need the weapons. Shit. I hate doing this. Every time I feel like more and more of a gigantic faggot. But I guess it's necessary in case I turn all Charles Manson and kill everyone.
Don't worry, he's clean. Until I get him alone, anyway.
Oh my god, you sound like a gigantic faggot.
Yeah, you see how you feel now? You pathetic little piece of shit. Bitch ass nuke. You. Come on. Not looking at her ass, I was getting my dogs out of my room. Shit. Come on.
The new vice president was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony at the White House this morning.
Now, the great question arises, will 47 get laid? Find out next time in the next episode. Just kidding, fuck you. Let's go back in here. Let's do it.
I'll just prepare myself for a bath. Don't move a muscle.
Wait, 47, you're doing something wrong. You're moving. You look a little bit bright, though. Holy crap. And they got a mirror up here, so when you're fucking, it's like, oh god, this is awesome. But how can I bend up that... How can I bend up that much? That's not even humanely possible. Like, you do like a full 360, and you don't even move your feet. You're just doing this. Whoa. This is creepy.
I'm not in the mood after all. I need a drink.
Yeah, I'll get you a poison drink. Oh, wait, where's the drink? The drinks are right over here.
I'm not in the mood. Go back down. I need a nap.
Are you done talking? She's talking to herself. Well, then again, so am I. Oh, crap. Cop's in the other room. This is useless. I keep on assuming that there's someone, like, talking to her. Alright, I think she's going to sleep now. Let's take what's ours, rightfully.
I'm not in the mood. Go back down. I need a nap.
Wait. No! Don't! But why?
Why would she do this to me? I thought we had something in common. Oh crap. Now that you mention it, she's probably gonna bring the fucking police. He's like, how do you do? Wait, what the fuck was I doing for the previous, like, no. Well, just go to sleep. Go. I'm not even going to be in the same room as you. I'm just waiting for you to fall asleep so I can do what I intended to. Bow chicka wow wow. Bow chicka. Bow chicka. Bow chicka wow wow. Bow chicka. Bow chicka. Bow chicka wow wow. Bow chicka bow. Bow chicka boom boom. Boom boom. Don't worry about me. You just go to sleep. I brought myself some toys. Let's have fun. Okay, being honest, things could have gone a little bit better. I'll be completely honest with you. Shit. Well, I don't regret a thing. I'm just gonna be making my leave now. Time to get that fat fuck of a husband dead. Why did I have to do that? Why do things always end up like this? Actually, I haven't even caught the attention of the guard, though, so it's not that bad. The new vice president was sworn in at a Rose Garden ceremony at the White House earlier this morning. Mr. Daniel Morris is not believed to have been the president's first choice. Is he still down here? Wait, he's in a safe room? Already? I'm gonna bring this out here. Move it over. Deal with all this shit, because Mr. Paranoid over here. Okay. Okay, our magic plan is complete. We're gonna do this. Then, we disable the power supply, and we make our escape. Simple as that. Man, this could use some music. Something like that. There you go. Well, I think things went better than expected, to tell you the truth. I tried doing this mission about 5 times. Every time I was triggering alarms and my cover was broken, every single time. It was either because of the fucking dog getting over here or going the other way. Or, I've never tried using the, garbage man as a cover, to go into another cover, to go into another cover. Now, let's see what our work is done. No. Hi, guys. I'm gonna call the phone and let them know I'm here. I said hi. I can't call the phone anymore, can I? Oh, yeah, I can. Why aren't they fucking answering?
Shh. Pathetic. But still.
I at least achieved some of my mission goals. I don't even care about the entire suitcase I probably left somewhere. I'm accomplished. I mean, I feel accomplished with my mission. And things did go better than expected. Thank you for watching. This is episode 5. One witness, one cover blown, two bodies found, zero headshots, accident zero, close combat kills too. Yeah, you can read it for yourself, but I'm a lean killer. Clean, lean, and a killing machine. Yeah, see ya.
Hello, 47. The American Secretary of the Interior is being targeted for assassination at today's Mardi Gras parade. We're not sure who's behind the hit, but our client wants you to prevent it by taking out the would-be assassins. There are three. The leader is Mark Pariah Jr. His associates are Raymond Kolinsky and Angelina Mason. Kolinsky's a former world-class biathlete, so he's probably the trigger man. Mason is probably just recon and support. They're romantically involved and mentally unstable, so expect a violent reaction if either of them learns the other is dead. Their whereabouts are a mystery, but we've identified the payment on its way to them. The money should lead you straight to them. There'll obviously be a lot of civilians in the mix on this one, and a high-profile hit like this is bound to have backup units on site, so you'll have to be even more discreet than usual.
There's the handoff.
Follow that briefcase, 47. It's the only lead we've got.
And then you notice the guys go in the complete opposite direction. Makes perfect sense. So, what's up guys? It's part 5 of our, Let's Play. No, wait, it's part 6. So, we're gonna chase this guy around, and we'll probably knock him down somewhere else. There are three assassins. Mark Pariah, Raymond Kolinsky, and shut the fuck up, bitch! Alright, you get the hint. There's three people we have to kill. We're gonna knock out this guy, take his suit, grab the case. Now, if you take the guy's case, the hit will never be completed, so you don't have to worry about that. So, just do what you have to do. Stalk this guy around a little bit. And, yeah, don't mind the advertising over there. That site is no longer active. It's my former site. I'd like to mod this game. Hey, what's up? You're so kind of casual.
No, I'm a brownie.
Are you fucking kidding me?
He just likes looking at me. He's not even going to say anything. Great. Just follow him around a little bit longer. You know, he's actually going to the direct place. Oh, look, there's a second assassin. The other pro. We don't have the killer just yet, but apparently he's going, like, straight towards this place. Wow. I wonder why, though. Well, he's gonna go this way. Just wait for him to do that shit. But now he's going in a complete opposite direction. Right there is where he's gonna do the handoff, but we're gonna have to stop that. Oh, now he stopped. So here's what we're gonna do. Grab this little fucker by the neck. And just move the little bitch around here. No one's really gonna notice if you do it fast. Nice and quiet now, because the other guard's gonna come in any second now.
You know what, buddy? I've about had enough of your fucking bullshit.
Kill him over here. Knock out that light. There you go. He's just gonna be left in the nice dark. Then you can take the briefcase and you won't have to worry about any of that shit. Surprisingly, the cops aren't coming around yet. I doubt they ever will, so, great. So you sure that's done? You go attack the second hit, who's over here. Now you can go across the place right over here without any problem, but if you hit the sidelines for some reason, they freak the fuck out. Not around here, but over here, watch. pulls out the gun and tells you to stop. That's kind of bullshit, but whatever. Go over here. Actually, it seems reasonable, you know what I'm saying? Because there's a gun right there, I could pick it up and shoot the fuck out of that guy. But I don't think they'll have a chance to care. This chick's coughing like a motherfucker. She's holding up the thing. Her boyfriend's probably gonna be... he's in the blues bar. Now, we're just gonna wait it out until she walks into the alleyway of this Latino club. She happens to go that way, but in about 5 seconds, she goes the complete opposite direction. So you're like, seriously? What the fuck? You have to go back and get your briefcase. Now that's done, you just keep on following her, like a stalker. Check the map. Since you're a casual, this is actually quite useful. You don't have to go searching around everywhere to find a place. This seems like the opportune time to take her out, knock her around, you know what I'm saying?
Chris Browner?
Don't hurt me, please!
Oh, fuck.
Our cover is blown.
Knock that cop out. Get the fuck out of here. Oh, shit.
You're not going anywhere. Release the house.
Oh, fuck.
Fuck.
Since that didn't really work out so well, we'll try a different strategy. Go around, kill the bitch first, and take care of everyone else second. We're gonna do this real simple, like. There we go. Took care of that. Now we just had to take out this cop next, and we won't have any witnesses. He's gonna give his trademark cough. He's gonna walk in, notice the dead body over there. Once he gets around to this corner, you'll be in the clear. And he dies of a hernia, or some shit like that. Just let him die of his wounds, and you'll be fine. Those guys are no potential witnesses. Just had to take out the second guy. So let's go find out where he is. Again, he's in the blues bar, so. Let's make our mark over there. And we'll take the secret way in because we don't have a disguise. Full on our pistols. Potential disguise could be used over there, but we're not even gonna bother. We're just gonna go in, sneak around the back, and hope for the best.
Stop it! Stop!
Knock this guy out. Push him along. For some reason, they don't seem to mind you stealing the chef uniform. And a trail of blood, you know. They'll just assume it's the fish or whatever. I don't think fish... Do they bleed? Yeah, they do bleed. Okay, so if you kill the fish or whatever kind of meat I was using, it was just a knife. Trust me. So, let's go confront him. Yes, nothing says good chef like a guy with fucking face paint. Yeah.
You look more like a juggalo.
Think that's funny, bitch? She's next. Let her move around as slowly as she does. Let her move around the back. There she go. Two accidents.
Breezy taught me.
And our contract's right over there. Let's do this cool. We don't need to use a gun for this shit. Find our target. And pop! He's dead. No alarm needed, just get the walkie-talkie. Maybe one of the outfits too, hopefully. Once I come around, they won't seem to mind. Take that. And we're gonna go for our third target. Raymond Kalinske. Oh wait, no, not Raymond. We're going for Mark Pariah. So that's just a brief walk upwards. We'll take the guy and then we'll take the suitcase, so our mission will be complete from there. Since we're one of them, they don't seem to mind. Just go up, introduce ourselves, and say, "What's up, guy?" Alright. For some reason, he doesn't seem to mind I'm wearing face paint and all that shit. Which is good, but, yeah. Wait for the pigeon to go out. Or the crow, or whatever the fuck he is. Once he goes out, close the door behind him. Take this old fucker. Get him around. Make your mark. Poison him, or whatever the fuck you want to do. There you go. And dispose of him. Because he's an ugly piece of shit with gay glasses. Once the other crow comes around with the payment, just make this your home in the meantime. I don't think they really care. So, just chill. Do whatever you want to do. This guy's gonna come in. He sees absolutely nothing wrong with his boss's disappearance. And just wait for him to come back out. In the meantime, we'll have to find the last crow, who is... Oh yeah, that's right. He's coming upstairs right now to give me my payment. Let's just chill in the meantime. Here's a nice, convenient outpost for you to do whatever the hell you want to do. You could hide in here for all I fucking care. And to make sure he's not a potential witness.
Hey,
oh,
what's going on?
Oh, fuck. Great. Great, 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 great. Well, sometimes things do go awry. And that's when you hide in here for the rest of the level. So. Thankfully, the entire police force isn't against me. Just a bunch of fucking crows. Oh, fuck! Let's handle this internally. Make sure the witnesses are all gone. Make sure all the fucking crows are in here, so we just have to kill these guys. Holy shit. I'm surprised they haven't even released the bullets yet. This guy doesn't even seem to know what the fuck's going on. Last crow doesn't even seem to care. Wow. Whatever. Suit up as him, since I don't think any of the cops are gonna come and check out this body. Take the briefcase. And, yeah. Get the hell out of here and never come back. Bitch. Alright. So we're gonna return to where we all started, and that is, I think, getting our original suit over at the blues bar. So once we got that done, everything's gonna go full circle, and we're getting the hell out of here and never coming back. This guy continues not to care, which is great. Just move up, move around. The chef's gonna be around the back, and we'll just take out the back way. So there we go. Take the briefcase and get the fuck out. Kinda weird how the music just stopped all of a sudden. Get up in here and get out. They don't seem to care. And the exit's right around the right, so here we are. End of story. Thanks for watching, guys. Beatstar here, and I'm out. Only three witnesses. That's great. We are the Eraser. Alright. Thanks for watching, everyone. I'm out.
It sucks being a seaman on a fucking fancy yacht. I had to work here all night. I had to clean up after these fucking people. And now who the fuck are you?
This is Agent 47. And you are visiting Hitman Forum.
Hello, 47.
Your next assignment's in the Rocky Mountains. Senator Bingham is being blackmailed by pornography tycoon Lorne de Havilland, who has a compromising video of the senator's son, Chad. The video shows Chad playing a little too rough with a nightclub dancer during a creative sexual tryst at one of de Havilland's adult nightclubs. The girl didn't survive the encounter. Senator Bingham's involved in a tight re-election campaign. The video could cost him the election. So could any future misbehavior by his son. Our client wants Havilland and Chad taken out. He also wants the videotape. The clients arranged for Chad to attend de Havilland's annual tax day party at the porn tycoon's mountain estate. We've got a recent photo of Chad, but de Havilland is camera shy, and the most recent picture we could get our hands on is 10 years old. This won't be easy, 47. The property isn't heavily guarded, but there'll be heavy security on the premises.
I was definitely a tryhard when I made that intro. God, I need to get laid. Alright, let's do this. Slide through here and, nope, you're not getting in, bitch. So yeah, we're gonna go and kill Lorne de Havilland and, that Chad motherfucker. But first, let's, get up here.
Good evening, sir.
No, thank you, I'd rather join the parkour club, bitch. Swag. Now I just need to get up. There we go. Now there's a motherfucker named Santa Claus over here. And he's funny as fuck until I stab him in the face. Let's go get him. Turn off the lights because I'm such a jerk. Yeah. You do that, punk. Bing! Now, dress up as Santa and go around everywhere. Now that you're Santa Claus, you're free to go through pretty much the entire floor, but you're not allowed to go into the studio or any of the staff floors. I tried doing it through another entry place, but I found out it wasn't worth it. So grab the aphrodisiac, you'll find out what I'm going to use this for later, and just mellow out. Right now is your downtime. There's like three sections of downtime here in this game. Looks like his drink isn't here. Hopefully he didn't just leave. Oh, fuck. There it is. That's the drink that we are going to spike. So he can have tons of crazy sex with all these bitches. Shit. Look at you, 47. You're nothing more than a fat fuck. Holy crap, I need to stop swearing. But, first off, we just need to just chill here. Mellow out, maybe go a little bit homo, huh? Actually, that was really gay. Let's wait for the other guy to come back. We still have a bit of downtime here.
Hey there, handsome.
Oh, well, thanks. It's really nice to know that 47 now is no longer balding and has hair and a soul patch right over here. That's great. Well, the guy's bringing back his drink, so we're just gonna go over here, wait for him to part with it, and spike it in here. Yeah, let's put in some roofies. I like how nobody minds at all that I just did that in front of all their faces, but, no matter. Let's go explore, shall we? Everywhere around here, the, really perverted photographer.
Hey, these babes are out of my league until I pick up a camera. Then I own them. They'll do anything. Anything.
God, your voice is more annoying than mine. Shit. So, you know what we do in this case? We save the game because... yeah, I have a feeling you know what's gonna happen. I'm gonna unpause. Get this. And shoot the fuck out of this bitch! Fucking punk! Think that's funny? Your high-pitched Alvin chickmunk-looking ass. Oh, fuck, fuck, fuck! God, I'm so surprised they don't even go into the waterfall. Otherwise, I would be screwed. Well, now we are Mr. Casual. And a nice, funky bitch over here is gonna give us a nice Marvin Gaye lovin'.
Sorry.
Men are so...
Psych! I just... Funkmaster Flex that out. Yeah, you thought I was gonna say Chris Brown, weren't you? Fuck you. But we're still on downtime, so... Let's just chill. Have a nice view of the, whatever the fuck it is, the overview of the compound. And, just chill. We're gonna be relaxing right now. Man, the weather's so breezy. Man, why can't life always be this easy? She and the mayor didn't seem so sleazy. I get a call like, "Where are you, Beezy?" And I said, "Fuck you, oh." Now, let's go check out the binoculars.
Yes, I am a foot fetish master. I know that is Chad Bingham's foot.
Now, we just have to wait till he gets out and goes to the place to have sweet, sweet love with that blonde woman. But we're still in downtime, so we need to make more efficient use of that. Oh, fuck! How the fuck did you guys know? Shit! I had no idea. Crap. You ain't gonna find me now, bitch. Shit. Oh, fuck. That blew our cover for sure now. Let's get going. Come on. How the hell did they know? Out of all people... They send those two assassins to come and get me, huh? Well, we should be safe for now. But I know there's people in here that are gonna go and try and kill us. So, we're gonna double up. Die already! Fuck! It was like a shank fest. Holy crap.
Come on. Get over here now. You're dead. I know it.
Hopefully they don't mind the puddle of blood. It's a good thing our cover is blown, but at least we have a new suit. Great. But this won't do us much good, because I'm pretty sure they're gonna go and check for another corpse. Alright. That's terrible vertical sink, you see that? Christ. They're going straight for the other corpse, aren't they? At least I changed mine in time.
Cause there's nothing suspicious about that, right?
My cover isn't completely blown. Crap, now they're getting suspicious. And this thing won't do us much good for long. So, let's go back to the main place and get ours. Let's see if Chad is actually back from his original post. Wait, how do I get down there? Take another... When we get spotted by all the guards, they're probably gonna give the suspicious thing. Gonna have to search you, sir. Oh, crap. I didn't even know that. Well, we'll probably have to go through all the saves back. And back to that perverted photographer guy. Back to being Santa Claus, huh? Let's let this guy pass, and hopefully next time won't be as stressful. Christ, such a failure. But this time nobody cares, which is great. They'll just notice a trail of blood and shit. Well, let's move the body over here. Nobody needs to see that. And we'll do the same thing to that crackhead hoe.
Yes, please invite me. Okay, let's go. Stop pointing at me already. Men are so special.
Men are so...
You wanna pull out anything, bitch? Better be a dick, no homo. Because it's my dick. I'm getting increasingly paranoid. I'm guessing it's from the surprise attack we had last time. That was really weird and scary. It doesn't seem like anyone's going after us right now, which is good. We just have to wait for good old Chad to come and jump us. I mean, jump some chick. Whatever, that was really weird. Let's go chill outside again. See if he's coming. Oh, I don't even have to look right now. That's obviously Chad's foot. Ugh. Chad will take the other way in for the place over here. Which should be, I think it's either this one or it's... Yeah, it's this one over here. It saves on time and you don't have to be stared at by a gazillion guards. He still doesn't have the spike drink, but I'm pretty sure it's on the way. There's a guy coming with the spike drink. Wait, are you telling me he wasn't in the mood? Oh, Christ. It sucks. I have to go and get another aphrodisiac, because that one obviously didn't work. Don't tell me the area's restricted either. Damn.
I'll just take this off your hands. Thanks.
Don't worry about it. Wait, so...
This will give you the extra...
I would love to have you update my portfolio.
Ah, it's funny. So, wait. Oh, there's Chad going right now. He should be in the actual back place, so... Hell, we had to race him there anyways. Yes, I'm pretty sure everyone likes pictures of belly buttons and butts and side boobs. Fuck. Just stalk him or whatever. Oh, crap. Guard. Well, here's what we're gonna do. We're just gonna wait around. Now, you might be thinking, this guy's straight, he's gonna get a lap dance, right? But as soon as I walk in, he's like, hell nah, I'm getting out of here.
Cock blocked.
Because you are a faggot. And the chick doesn't mind either, she just goes her own way. This guy's gonna go the complete opposite direction. I'll just wait for him to leave.
Cock blocking.
And it will be time for me to make my move. We can do this in various different ways. One, simply pushing the guy down by punching him or whatever the fuck. Good thing nobody saw. But he's still alive, so we'll just have to make the final mark. That's to shoot him in the face. Objective complete. And luckily, not as much witnesses are gonna notice, because that guard only goes through here. He never comes down unless you shoot the roof or anything, which luckily we didn't do. But we're not completely done with our mission. We have to go and get a snossage to poison, and then we'll kill the other faggot, Lorne de Havilland. It's a good thing they continue not to care, because otherwise that would continually be bad. So, go ahead and whip out the poison and inject this meaty substance with vitamin...
Yes. It's great. If we have to get searched, we're going the other way, because I don't have time for that bullshit.
Gonna have to search you, sir.
Are you kidding me? Go and chase me, punk. I'm going the back way. Because luckily, no guards, like, mention that, but if you go through the main way, they all go all freaky, and I don't get that at all. Because see, I'm already in the back area. They didn't even need to search me. Now, watch this. This is the way to the studio. They visibly wave their way for me to go ahead. But if I want to go into the grotto, they have to search me. That's complete and utter bullshit. First of all, the waiter can get past that, but if you go through here, he has to get searched. He shouldn't even be allowed at all, but still. Huh. Oh, crap. We're in the helipad. That's not where we want to go. We want to go to the studio. This is our second save point. We shall make right about here. Because things have a tendency to go awry around here, and especially if you're around the edge. We're going to do something really cool if we have the chance. That Lauren bastard is over here. Yep, and his fucking annoying dog. Good thing this sausage is poisoned. Just whip that out over here. Know what we do with this? We do this. Dog can shut the fuck up because it ate that poison sausage. Go ahead and die already. What the hell are you? It's like you're cheery and yeah, now you're dead. Great. Just nonchalantly leave the building. You can leave through the helipad or the other way. If you leave through the helipad, it's a lot more tedious and annoying. So if you go through the other way, obviously it'll be a lot more convenient. Let's go back to the first floor and get back our last thing, which we are missing, and that is the suit. Once we got that, we're easy sailing all the way home.
Yeah. Damn.
Surprisingly, these guys are getting... Nope, they're not getting suspicious. That's great. There shouldn't be any witnesses since the guards don't typically go that way. Fortunately, I'm a staff member, apparently, or he didn't look around. This fat bastard. The lights are still out on. Let's go get our suit. Not the knife, the suit. There we go. And make our way out of this building. He's looking like a boss, if I must say so. Just for kicks, let's go and go around the other. I know I love saving that much, but still. He told me, get lost, Chumley. I even heard it. Oh. Look, I made the jump. What the fuck are you gonna do, bitch? Yeah, I wish I could spit in game, too. And then I'd make him all flip out and shit. Well, at least we have our suit, all of our guns, and we actually picked up some new toys, like two aphrodisiacs, a pistol, and a kitchen knife. I wonder how we're gonna utilize that in the next mission. Actually, probably not, because the next mission sucks balls. Probably not even going to do an episode on that. And, you know, the most surprising part is I think we weren't even caught on camera. Yeah, nothing. It's great. So, let's see what we got. Oh, fuck.
We missed it. How could we? How could we be so naive?
I'm a good-intentioned assassin, but, like, when I miss stuff, it makes me feel really bad about myself. And it should, but still. Crap. We traded a Santa suit for another suit. They won't have the time to call me Chumley. And that guy ain't a snitch, which is good, because he's also black. But still. Oh, fuck! They see me. Hi, hater. It's a good thing they don't care about the undressed body. Not even here. Huh. Alright, let's go get that videotape. It's on the studio level, so it's quite a journey. This guy has a tendency to be a dick. We could pick the lock and take our chances, but... Yeah, I know. Saving a gazillion times. Or we could take the shortcut and waste 4 extra minutes.
Fuck that.
Not a chance, sucker. And the tape will be where you think it is. In one of the places over here. I think it is up and left. Yep. There it is. Oh, crap.
No trespassing, fella. Get out of here.
Is here okay? Wait, anywhere's not okay? Are you kidding me? How about here? Crap. You kidding me? This effing guy, of all guys. You know what we're gonna do? Well, we can't kill him because we're gonna keep short on these witnesses killing and stuff. Just knock him down over there. He'll still count as a witness in the end of the mission, but at least I want to deal with most of his bullshit. I got this punk and get the videotape. So that's 2 punks knocked out. That one's over there. Now we can finally go back and get whatever we wanted. Everything's done. Thank God. This wasn't my longest episode, I think. So, at least we tried. That was the weirdest beginning I ever heard. I thought that was like another song altogether. Because I'm really familiar with the soundtrack, you know what I'm saying? Because I've been playing this game for so long. Cool with the staff-only entrances. Yeah, this guy doesn't seem to mind. But if we go to the other place, they flip out. I'm guessing that's the Haverland's only place he can go to. Or the only place he has access to. As well as the bodyguards. But now that we have our suit... should be clear to go back home. Now, what I wanted to say is, around here and another entrance, which is around the pier, there are security cameras, and the only reason why I wasn't caught under them is I was sneaking under doing some splinter cell shit. Nah, just kidding. I'll just show you. Look at those pants, so light on you, 47. Yep, the camera, if you go through anywhere over here, it'll detect it. Which is why you just slip over. Nobody seems to mind that you're intentionally dodging the cameras, but... you know what? That all becomes irrelevant now that we're escaping this mission. Now that the dead guy's on this fucking yacht, let's go, rape this corpse. No witnesses. No covers blown. No bodies found. 2 headshots, 5 kills, 3 shots hit. Oh, that's a lot of waste of bullets. But still, it was good. This is great. I am now officially a stalker. I got that rating in the demo run of this level. Yeah, I know I demo run this shit because there was a gazillion ways this mission could go wrong, and I just picked the best way out of all of them. Still, it was a good mission. Fuck it. Merry Christmas, motherfuckers.
Nice to be back in civilization, 47.
It suited me. I had some business to attend to.
Those missions out in the sticks may have bought us some time, but things are still deteriorating rapidly. We're still losing agents. You got the briefing?
Yesterday. Got the pictures right here. Mohammed bin Faisal Al Khalifa, his scientist Tariq Abdul Latif, and Henrik Schmutz of South Africa. Interesting trio.
The DNA angle's disturbing. This may tie into the group that's trying to liquidate us.
Quite a long vacation.
Top straight, motherfucker.
I forgot to ask, but who the hell are you?
I am D-Beats.
That's a pretty gay name. Why do they call you that?
Because I am a chauffeur. Don't you know about stereotypes?
No, listen, I gotta go. I'll see you later. Nigga.
Get the fuck out.
Asshole. Okay, hey guys, what's going on? BeatStar here, and we are playing Let's Play Hitman Blood Money Part 8. I know we aren't playing Let's Play, but yeah, fuck it. So the first thing we're going to do is go over here and get our...
I have a reservation.
Reservation.
The name is Cropes.
Let's see. There it is. Here's your key card. Our new key cards are floor specific, so they only give you access to the floor you're staying on.
This guy's like staring at me.
Alrighty then, on behalf of Shamal Hotel and Casino...
And then this bitch says the same thing.
Alrighty then, on behalf of...
Wow, that bitch coughed like a motherfucker. Alright, go get your key card, and after this 10-day absence, let's go and make ourselves at home. Our room should be on over here. So let's see where we come up to. Well, there's a scientist. Let's go check out our room. Oh, wrong way. Well, let's go see what we have. Shotgun. A pimpin' ass bathroom. Is that two bedrooms? Oh, that's just one. Still really nice. And look, there's a TV. Let's go watch what's going on. Okay, let's go change the channel. So, let's get all up close and personal with these bastards. For example, here's one of them right now. He's sucking lips with this fine dame. Watch them as they enter this room. Now it is our job to intrude on them. And kill them fucking both! You! What the fuck? I really gotta stop dreaming. Dumb bitch. No. Get away from me, you stinking woman.
Only the line girls!
Alright. Let's go get our first target. Going on the left one. Shit. Bastard took my spot. Let's
Let's go wait for this fuckface. How you doing, man? Don't worry about it.
Sorry, sir. You need a key card.
Yeah, right. I just have a save file, bitch. Deal with it.
For this floor. Hey!
I'm such a badass. Let's go hide in the corner over here. It's our room now, bitch. Alright, so let's go get our first target. That should have gone a little bit more low profile than I thought. Fuck. At least we tried. Shit. Let's get around. Fuck! You sons of bitches! Ah, fuck. We're fucked beyond belief. And at least I killed the first guy. Let's just climb up here and hopefully no one will see us. Holy crap, that mission could have gone a lot better. But at least we got our first guy. What? He's going the other way? Oh, this is gonna suck. It's not like any of these fuckers are gonna come by. But you know what? He is coming back. Great. Let's go hide up in here. He better be taking this spot. Sweet.
Baraku, bitte ist a pizza of shit.
Wait. I'm a pizza of shit? Yeah, whatever you say, buddy. Just get the fuck up here. And fuck yeah, they die is. I am a pizza, though. Holy crap. There we go. Let me dress up as this guy. Nothing suspicious about that. Stop doing that fucking move your fucking hand and put it in your beard. That's a little bit creepy. Oh, wait. Let's go back to floor 8. We have to give a gift to the Sheik. To really take that long. Who made me move back up? There's a dead guy in here. I gotta get a new key card, but how? Is this taking me back up here? It's not gonna do me much good. I don't really need this. Ugh. Let's save this again, and then we're gonna go see if this guy has the key card for the 8th floor. If he does, then I'm just stepping over his corpse. Hopefully no one will care.
Who did this?
Me. This is great.
I just took the key card and nobody fucking saw. Let's get going. But I can't go to the 8th lobby. Why? I do have a key card there.
We're in the 8th lobby, retard.
Oh. Well, in that case, why am I standing around here? Let's go see if there's anything else. Oh, crap. He has the briefcase. There's only two ways to do this. One's doing this. And the other is... I don't know. Hopefully the explosion will make him think of something else. Take the briefcase. And you know what? We don't even need our suit, now that we have the briefcase. We just gotta have to say hello to Mr. Sheikh Al-Khalifa. Fuck. Let's go and find this punk and blow him to bits. Any second now. Alright, let's get going. Down here, we have to be really careful of the cameras because they can be a real pain in the ass. Shit. Well, it looks like there's no avoiding them. Just go down with a smile on our face. Just do it.
Politics is so bad.
Yep, there we are. Caught on camera. Looks like our boy's there. We need a better throw. Come on, 47. Pull it together.
Okay, shut up.
There we go. Let's do it.
Stop that guy.
Shit. Alright, understood, partners. I'ma get going. Sorry, it's just the only way I could get out of here. Fuck. How do I get out of here? Oh, that's right. Fuck you, bitches. I'm out of here. I sure am a lunatic. But only three witnesses, which is pretty good, considering the fact that we had to blow up a motherfucker, kill the sheikh, and strangle a white supremacist. Looks like this lunatic kills again. And that should be about it. Thanks for watching, guys. I'm probably going to do the next episode in a week.
Or fucking less!
Yeah, all right. Good one there.
It's been fun. Remember the times when I killed that guy? Oh, wait, that was like 7 times. But yeah, you get the point. It's a shame that's all gonna come to an end soon. Might as well live it up.
It's over, 47. I'm closing shop at this end.
I know.
This will be your last assignment. There are two targets. Varna Ketlin, a former Romanian circus performer who's now a big player in the global grey market, and a CIA operative who's been playing both sides of the fence. Ketlin's hosting a masquerade party at the Shark Club in Vegas, and the CIA op will be there to close a deal. Even if this job isn't a setup, your presence will almost definitely be expected. You're our only surviving agent, 47. Find out whoever it is that's been coming after us. Eliminate both targets, and anyone that targets you, and exit in the vehicle I'll have ready for you in the parking garage. You've been a very effective agent. It's been pleasant to work with you. I hope the future is kind to you.
Don't cry. I'll be here next episode. I promise.
Shut up, Jensen.
So that's the deal.
Anything else?
It'll probably be crawling with that.
Have you identified them?
They're paid by the Ashnerf.
The Ashnerf? That's Parchesi's group. What's their business here tonight?
I think you are. You and I are all that's left of the Agency 47, and I doubt I'll survive much longer.
I'm sorry to hear that. Has my fee been transferred?
More than usual. I'm splitting what's left of the Agency's resources with you. It's been quite a ride. Good luck, 47.
Good luck yourself.
While we're far from Horatio Kane, it seems that we're at the end of a very, very long rope. Well, let's do this.
Anything ever happen?
What?
See, if I had more fats and the lost so in the past that they say fear been fell out.
No one told me about any fear.
Are you Fuck saying you. It's been stolen?
Hold on, hold on, I'll check.
What an asshole. Well, let's just wait around here, very suggestively, while we get the stereotypical guard having pornographic... Oh wait, no, that's like a fucking design magazine or some shit like that. Wait for him to get back there and sedate his ass. Sedate your ass! Oh. I meant to go for the ass. Sorry, bro.
No homo.
Or Frank Ocean. Go get his outfit. And right now you have about 30 seconds until the guard comes up here. So you have tons of free time. The guard won't go back here. He'll only mingle around this area. So you can go ahead and take any guns you want. And we'll get the next disguise. As expected. Here it comes right now. He's like, oh my god, it's you. But he doesn't seem to care. There's another guard. And let's get our disguise for Heaven. It should be just right over here. And it's real simple. All you have to do is go over here, push a button, and there you go. The heavenly music plays, allowing you access into the club. Now you might be thinking, why don't I go over here? You know, it's the easiest way up, right? You're fucking wrong, bro. The second you go up here, they're gonna search you. And you're gonna be like, hell nah, no way. So, just ditch around there. See this guard over here? Easily distracted by coins and shit. Let's get up. And go around. And this is the best way to go up here without killing 50 million people. There you are. Already up on the top floor. And we will be making our next round in probably around 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 3, 2, 3, 2, 1? Oh no. We'll just troll around. We got two targets up here. We got the shitty dancer and the CIA agent. Why am I saying CSI? Maybe it's the intro I made. Sorry, I was lagging. Alright. Let's go find the CIA agent first. He should be around here, probably taking a piss. There he is, right over there. Now, just mingle around for a little bit longer. Oop, sorry, bro. I'm sorry. Look at all these guys, all freaking out and shit. Why are you putting your hand like that? I'm already out. Let's just, listen to her shittily dance or sing. Let's talk
Enjoying
to this guy.
Enjoying the party so far, sir?
No, so I'm not. Far. It sucks.
Some pretty amazing babes, huh?
No.
You catch a singer? Damn, is she hot. Terrible singer, though.
No
I
shit.
I hadn't noticed.
Oh, yeah, I had a great singer lined up, but she had a fatal accident yesterday, and they needed a real quick replacement.
Sounds legit. Hey, look, it's a CIA agent. Looking at me all weird and shit.
Hey there, sexy.
Sup? Let's do this. Alright, that's enough. I just can't take any more of this shit. You know, if we learned anything in the past episodes I've made, is that coins fucking interrupt performances. Yeah. Awkward. Everyone shuts up and looks at me. Watch this shit. I can have them all staring at me like this. They stop everything they're doing and just look at the fucking coin. Yes, this is a coin. I know you jelly. And even though you can throw it at people, it doesn't really, like, affect them, which surprises me a little bit. So, this guy's taking a piss again. And we're just gonna have to wait for him to go downstairs to hell. Because if we kill him in here, in about 5 minutes, somebody's gonna find his body and we will be screwed. Well, we're not screwed. We just have a witness we don't have to deal with, you know what I'm saying? He's cleaning up right now. Hopefully we find that assassin. Where is she? She kind of blends in with everyone.
Oh, hey, wait. Gorgeous. You're looking good. Follow me.
Oh, totally. You're not an assassin sent to kill me. I believe you. Let's go. Wow, that was a journey. Alright. Race you over here. I said race, bitch! A little bit closer. A little bit closer. Perfect. Now all we have to do is move her over here so no one sees her blood body. They don't really care about the blood as much as somebody laying on the ground dead. So let's just put him over the desk, or put her. And look, the rifle suitcase. Go get the info. And much should we know, this is the first assassin we have to kill. You can get the rifle briefcase, but there's not much use for it. You know, seeing as the other guy has one. If you want to unlock this thing, just do that. And leave. Surprisingly, they don't care if you go through either way. See? But if you try going back, they freak the fuck out. That guy's still cleaning up. Holy crap. And the game is slowing down and shit. I don't really get that. Huh, there's our guy. Hopefully he's going the way I expect, and that's downstairs. We'll be able to kill him in the elevator, so there won't be any body to be found, and we can take his disguise. Wait for this thing to close and get up here. Now we wait. Hopefully grabbing the fiber wire we're gonna need. He's coming down in a while. Now, if you're a anything under a professional, would be a good time to save and just wait for this son of a bitch. He's gonna talk with one of the people and then he's gonna come down. I'm gonna stop recording for now because it's a long ass time. And I'll re-record when he comes over here. Here's one of the moments when you know he's gonna come downstairs. He'll talk to one of these people. He'll fuck it up because he's a beta. Actually, an omega because he's a total socially awkward motherfucker. Like me, but, you know, more introverted. So, here he comes right now. Grab out the firewire to be prepared. And here he is, coming downstairs. Grab him. And there you go. Now, if you want to take his
suit, free to do so. Just make sure you do it quick. I had to close the door because my dog just got in here. And just leave. Nobody seems to care that you're a completely now bald person with a barcode on the back of his head. Then again, nobody has. Tonight. Thank you. I know. And because apparently you're supposed to be the owner of this hotel or shark club, you're free to go up and down as you please. Our second guy's killed. Now we have to only deal with the last two. We'll kill Mayweather John first, and then we'll kill Vonna Ketlin, the bitch.
Yeah, I don't regret it.
It's only a short distance away. Here's our guy.
Ah, Mr. 47. The fates conspire to throw us together at last.
I appreciate your enthusiasm.
Don't be coy with me, 47. I know all about you.
Yeah, right.
You're just the ungainly outcome of a childish experiment with genetic tinker toys. Super assassin, indeed. You're less than human, and I intend to prove it.
How do you intend to do that?
We're going to duel. Meet me in the room marked torture chamber.
Oh, okay. You know, the thing that you would prove me to be less than human is not moving your fucking lips when you were talking. Yeah, totally believe that. Alright, so let's just get going. I don't have really much time to deal with this shit. Here we are. Conveniently, a guard's right outside the torture chamber, but apparently, they're soundproofing.
Here we stand, the world's best and second best assassins. Only the former will leave this room alive. The soundproofing will prevent any interruptions. Your equipment is positioned by the couch. Arm yourself appropriately, my mutant adversary, and we'll commence.
If that's what you want.
Oh shit, cue up the battle music! And motherfucker, I got a rifle case, so your ass is dead! Let's get going. Where the fuck are you, bitch? Oh, I see you. Oh! Oh, fuck! I got this. I win, motherfucker. Grab this. Yeah, you didn't expect me to cheat now, did you? Now, if you're having fun or you're extremely bored, you can destroy basically anything in this room. Just shoot a little bit and it'll break. You can shoot the vases too. But you're just wasting ammo. Also, there's a bunch of ammo, speaking of which, that is right over here. So, go and take it if you need it. And leave the room with a sense of self-accomplishment. You don't need this briefcase anymore. You might as well just throw it anywhere. Yeah, like over there, where it can't fall. And leave. The last thing we have to do... Yeah, I know. I hate saving this game. But we're doing this with no witnesses, which makes me extremely surprised. The last thing we're gonna do is kill the bitch in an accident. And by doing this, we do something like this.
Like,
we go over here. Yes, right over here. Into the security area. Wait for this guy to leave. And then we're gonna fuck up the pyrotechnics. Didn't mess with anything, bruh. Trust me. Vonna isn't anywhere to be seen, which is a good thing. And we'll just wait for her performance. Oh shit. Let's get out of here so she doesn't notice us. Because if she sees us, she's going to invite her to the room and that will mess up everything. Because she'll ask me to remove my mask. Obviously, since I'm not the CIA agent, she'll get really pissed off. So just chill over here with the guards. You won't really have to worry about anything. If you want your health to be high like I do, just take some painkillers. Just mellow out. There isn't really much you can do except wait. She's gonna go over and do her grand performance, and for the finale, you're gonna see what happens.
So let's just walk over there. Wait for her to do her show. Here she comes right now. Down there, over here. Or if you're extremely bored, you can pretend to chill with everyone, all the dancers over here, with the crowd system all dancing at once, like total idiots. You call that dancing, motherfucker? Oh my god. It's like the Soulja Boy's commonplace here.
Hey, handsome.
Oh shit. Oh shit. You hear that alarm? Real shit's going on. I just don't know what. Where's Vanna at? Oh shit, there she is.
I am going to dance for my boyfriend.
Yeah, you do that.
Man, you guys are coming upstairs.
I can't wait to get out of this outfit.
Thank you. Why would I say thank you? I'm so socially awkward. Like that CIA agent. Good thing I'm dressed as him. Yeah. Totally emo music. I enjoy this very much. Crap. Alright. Right now! The finale. Yes! The best part of the whole thing. You're on fire!
Hey, that's a Richard Price, hey.
And watch this, the shark's gonna eat that bitch.
Oh yeah, and thank you, Kanye West.
Boom! Love this shit. Look at everyone clapping. This was an A+ performance. And the best part? No witnesses. Well, now that we got everything finished, I guess all we have to do is go upstairs. Alright, pull it together, BZ. Oh crap, why did I go down here? All we have to do now is get our suit. Just ignore any fucker that tries to tell us that we're not supposed to be here, and we'll be finished with the mission. So come on, any minute now. And what we're to do now is, oh fuck. Now we have to get the videotape. This shit sucks. And why else to do that than get the fucking suit back? Goddamn videotape. Make sure to record or save one last time. I know I'm not gonna be doing this shit anymore. Fuck. But once we do this, all we have to do is get our suit back and not deal with anything else. You have to do it really carefully. It's mostly a thing of chance.
What you gotta do right now is turn around and leave.
Because they all apparently care if you're...
What you gotta do right now is turn around and...
Are you kidding me? Fuck. Where do we get this guy's outfit from? Oh, yeah. So I can go into both parts of the club, the place that I fucking own, but as soon as I walk in one of those guards' place, they get all fucking pissed off. You know how much fucking sense that makes? Shit. We gotta wait for this douchebag to move over. I should kill those faggots, but that might hurt my fucking silent assassin rating. Ugh. I'm pretty sure I'm not even gonna get it. Wait for this guy to turn around. Just
done smoking a stooge. Any day now. Fuck. All right, let's get going. Just get that and get back in our regular suit, which should be over here. We'll wait for the guy to leave and we should be in the clear. You know what? I've had enough of this shit. I probably didn't even have to sedate the guy, but I'm getting tired of this. He's sleeping. Don't even worry about it. We're gonna go downstairs and ignore any motherfucker that tries to tell us we're not supposed to be here. Finally get into that damn van of ours. Hey, we might even make it without him noticing. There we go. Awesome cutscene, by the way.
Hey, 47.
Fuck you!
Oh, hey!
Shut the fuck up, bitch! I'm so mean like that.
It's me! It's me!
Nope.
Stop! It's me! I'm cool! Come on!
No, you're not.
What are you doing here?
Just relax, please! You're my only hope.
Yeah,
there's
right.
No one else.
Your only hope for what?
They're gonna kill the president. Don't want him reelected. He'll legalize cloning, ruin their plans.
Who are they?
You know, them. Already got a cloning program. Want the technology to themselves.
They can have it. I don't play politics. Now give me one good reason why I shouldn't put a bullet in your head.
I've got millions. Got the diamonds
you
back
there.
You
saved his ass last time?
Red suitcases worth millions. All yours.
What's the job?
They want to hit the president in 3 days, in the White House. You get in there, protect him, take the assassins out.
Show me the money.
Thank God. Here's some. You get the rest after.
Okay.
What do you say?
I'll contact you with instructions on how to get me the rest of the money up front, and how to get me the mission details.
But then how can I be sure that...
If you're on the level, I'll do the job. If you're not, you won't be needing the money.
And I'ma just ditch you without even letting anyone get you a ride. Peace, bitch. And that's it of that level. Let's see what I got. Yeah, I like that. Silent Assassin. That's all I wanted out of this fucking game, to get a Silent Assassin rating, but I never managed one. Now I have that confidence to, have it. Thanks for watching, guys. This isn't the last episode, but we're getting close.
Hey guys, what's going on? Today we're going to be checking out Call of Duty Black Ops 2. I'm trying really hard to make my voice sound wacky and cool and extreme. Hey guys, what's going on? Hey guys, what's going on?
Okay, so last episode, Agent 47 discovers Agent Smith in his van. He dips over, puts the gun to his fucking head, and asks in a very formal fashion, "Give money, please." And of course he does give money. But the assignment is something different. He is about to kill the Vice President of the United States. So, with the money gibbed, he dips out of that bitch and never comes back.
That was the best intro ever. What the fuck are you talking about?
We're all quite pleased to have you on this assignment, Mr. 47. The nation's gratitude...
Skip the patriotism, Smith.
Of course. Have you read the briefing?
Not yet. Give me the big picture.
The Vice President of the United States is plotting with Mark Parcheesi. I assume you're familiar with him?
I know his work.
Good. They're planning to assassinate the President as soon as he gets back from Los Angeles.
Another drink, sir?
Kubi.
Please.
There's more detailed info on both men in the briefing.
Okay.
Can I do anything else for you?
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to finally working with you.
I'll contact you if I need more information. Beyond that, never contact me in person again.
And another cutscene.
Sorry, gentlemen. My niece's birthday. Happy birthday, sweetheart. Did you get your present?
Uh-huh. It's everything I've ever wished for. My own access card to the White House. Is the roof alarm taken care of?
Yes, Pumpkin. Everything is just fine.
I'm afraid Uncle has to go now.
But why?
I'll call you back later and we can talk all about your party.
Fine.
Meanie.
You know how little girls are.
Get it? Because it's a fucking guy.
Listen up, 47. The President of the United States is about to be assassinated. You'd expect the CIA, FBI, or Secret Service to prevent the assassination, but we can't rely on them. We can't rely on them because the man behind this assassination is the acting Vice President. The same shadowy group that got him appointed to the Vice Presidency wants to put him into the Oval Office. They've got pull at every domestic agency. The assassins are probably already in position, in the White House. Unless you can stop them, the President will almost certainly be assassinated as soon as he returns from Los Angeles. Your targets are the notorious assassin, Mark Parcheesi III, and the Vice President himself.
Well, here's the last mission. The last big one, anyway. So, as you may know, there are three ways of starting this mission. One's getting the guns and throwing them over the rail. The other one is putting a bomb or a gun into this bitch's briefcase. And the third one, you know, is dropping a bomb into the bathroom and waiting for a guard to pick it up. But, more or less, it's the same boring shit every YouTuber uses on their videos. So, here's one technique I like to use. Once you spawn on the level, go straight forward. Sounds simple, right? That's because it is. All you have to do is go straight forward, keep on going, a little bit further, and here we are. Now, pick up the Spaz 12, and kill him fucking off!
Come on, Agent 47, no way to spread the fury of Cthulhu! You want some kill? Kill the black guy! And the guards! Kill this guy! And the last target!
Alright, that should be about it for this level. No witnesses. Suck my dick, camera. Let's just check outside, just in case. Looks like we're in the clear, so let's keep on going.
Aren't we forgetting something, 47?
Why, yes, we are. We're forgetting the keycard. And the videotape. Now that we have the videotape, we will no longer be able to be caught on camera. The cameras will keep on moving, but, we won't have to deal with our ugly, balding face being on them. I wonder if they can run barcodes through cameras. Shit. My tendency to digress has gotten the best of me. Let's keep on going, shall we? Oh look, a guard. Time to pop his fucking face! Man, that was satisfying. Next one, watch this. We aren't gonna shoot at him directly, we're gonna shoot the wall so it gets his attention. Alright, now hide behind here. And wait for the sexually repressed bastard to come. Pause. Pop him. Shit! That asshole isn't gonna shoot us, we're gonna have to come to him. Let's blast his ass on the full clip.
Can somebody say no homo?
No, bitch. And now, we gotta get the vice president. But to ensure no bodies are found, we have to kill all these fucking bastards. But oddly enough, they're all swarming like idiots. They're not even going to my location, which I don't get at all. Yeah, whatever. On a count of three. 3, 2, 1! I got my game back. Let's do this. Damn straight, motherfucker. Let's get going. Shut the fuck up! You too, bitch! And the fucking dog! I ain't give a fuck! I told you I was a trail nigga. I don't even give a fuck if I'm white. I'm black on the inside. That's all that matters. Now, the vice president. Where is that son of a bitch? Oh, hello. There you are. I was looking all over for you. Psych! Boo!
Hey guys, what's going on here?
A dead motherfucker club. Care to join?
Yes.
So, with the music subsiding, that leaves everybody here dead. In other words, that means we're in the clear for now. Go ahead, organize the bodies. You know, we need to do some little home improvements. So, move this fucker into this room. There you go. Close the door. And you can leave that right there. All we have to do from here is change into the Secret Service uniform. Picked up a card, which you already did. And survey the upstairs. Make sure nobody comes downstairs. So far, it seems clear. But you can never be too sure. So, you know, in the meantime, pick up the Spaz 12. And do some home renovations. You know, paint the walls with blood. Nobody's over here. Ah, I see where they are now. Wrong one. One more over. Surprise! What? He doesn't even know? What a fucking retarded guard. Shit. Actually, look how fast he walks. It's like he's jogging down the stairs, and with the feet, he's like moving super duper fast. Are you looking at that shit? I'm gonna zoom in right here. Look at that shit.
Would you please? I'm walking at a normal pace.
Dude, what the fuck do you think you are, bitch? Sonic? I beg to differ, motherfucker. Gotta go fast! Now that we have one bullet left and this gun doesn't really match our attire, let's drop it. And go straight to the west wing. Oh shit. Wrong way.
Wait, it could be the right way.
No, wrong way, motherfucker. Let's get going. It's this way. But before we go, make sure we get two things. One is the gun, and make sure you move these guys out of the way so the door can shut. Yeah, like that. Close the door. So it looks, you know, nice. And let's get going to the west wing. After another short but awkward silence, the Oval Office is just on this pathway. All I have to do is jog a little bit longer, make a right, and swipe ourselves in. There we go. Was that so hard? And look, people are suspicious already. That's great. So now we're gonna have to kill Parchezzi. Get out the gun you want to use, like this one. Go into first person.
So, you're the famous Mark Parchezzi III.
No shit, Agent 47. Were you dropped as a child?
Our similarities are irrelevant.
We're practically brothers. You can't shoot me.
I can do whatever I'm paid to.
Now quickly shoot this smug albino bastard. You'll waste a clip, but at least he's dead and you don't have to do some gay chase. Holster your weapon because the Secret Service is coming and leave the place. Here they are, right on time. Now, get going. If you're playing this professional and you want your suit back, well, here it is. Just go ahead and pick it up and continue on your way out of this dump. You might have noticed since we killed everyone on the way here, there won't be any guards to stop us there. So get through here, you go down this door, keep on walking. You know, I'm actually surprised I never saved this. This was like my second attempt at the level, using my method, of course, and I never had to save because it's so simple. God damn, why do all these kids have to do all these elaborate stunts and shit? Whatever. Looks like we're done. But fuck, they found a body. Well, if we're fast enough, they don't count as a witness, so let's get going and gone. So that seems to be about it, and yes, no witnesses. It's a good thing, too, because otherwise I'd be fucking pissed. Just kidding, I don't take this game that seriously. Is that it? For the entire game? The entire series laid out in the palm of our hands? No more episodes of Hitman Blood Money? What? Barack Obese, you must be crazy. Why? Why you fool us so much? Why you no give fuck? Why you no make more Stanley Rue videos? Because I do my own thing, motherfucker. And we're done. Just kidding. So we have this last cutscene we have to watch her. Spoiler alert. I'm not even gonna say it. So we're just, you know, polishing our guns, doing the routine stuff before our mission, and we notice something strange. God damn it, Birdie, shut the fuck up. Oh wait, it's something else. Let's go cock my gun. You gotta move, bro. Let's get going. Over here. Turn the radio off. You gotta shut the fuck up. Or I'll make you.
Me, 47, Diana.
What are you doing?
You know the rules, no girls allowed.
Sneak in. The place is surrounded by hundreds of SWAT members right now. They're getting ready to move in. I had to warn you, there's still time for you to escape. I've got a plan.
Give me that. Wait, how do I read this shit? You know I'm dyslexic.
I don't buy it. You've got nothing to gain here. The smart play would have been getting out of the country.
Out of the country? We're dealing with the Irish now for the 47. Borders don't stop them. You're my last chance.
You know my terms. Cash on the nail.
Don't you get it? You have to fight them. But if you try to do it alone, you're a dead man.
Death is always a risk.
Read carefully, 47. It's a bold plan.
Where is this wheelchair guy right now? Bitch!
You didn't answer my question! Where is this wheelchair guy, you dumb motherfucker?
We've got 4 minutes before he's called, people. Let's move.
Of course, the wheelchair guy doesn't go down the stairs.
I've never actually killed a man before. It was surprisingly pleasant.
Very nicely done, Diana. You've earned my trust. Welcome to Sajnerf. I'm sure we'll find an appropriate role for you in the organization. A woman like yourself is entitled to a very special role indeed.
Assassination attempt was the most reported story since 9/11. How can you expect me to believe that?
I don't expect you to believe anything but your eyes. This videotape confirms his presence in the White House moments before the assassination.
I'll be damned.
If cloning isn't outlawed, we'll all be damned.
Who actually killed him?
That's the most delicious irony of all. He stumbled coming over the compound wall, severed his spinal cord on the rocks. The world's most nefarious assassin died of clumsiness.
How'd you confirm his identity?
Hopefully not
his
Wikipedia.
His DNA includes signature sequences from the five men of the Ortmeier Project. It's biologically impossible for anyone but the Ortmeier clone to have that DNA.
Thanks. You're giving me all this as an exclusive. Why me?
We admire your objectivity, Rick.
That nigga's gay.
Thank you.
Don't mention
it. Good thing I'm not.
We need to get to the chaplain. 47's ashes are going to take pride of place on my mantle.
Tasty.
Chaplain! Chaplain!
Here we are. The end.
Psych! Die, all you bitches! Every single one of you faggots that try to kill me! Ugh! Reload, damn you!
And this last bastard, kill him, 47.
Okay, I will when I reload. Shut the fuck up! There. They got backup on the way, though. Should I hide here? No, I'll face him head on. You see me? Now die! Shit. No ammo. Might as well stab him instead of using the extra gun. Cry. Your tears are delicious.
Now all we have to do is find and kill this Rick bastard and make him cry. One last African journey, please.
Mom isn't gonna save you now, bucko! It's time to punish you.
That's enough punishing in one lifetime. Just pop him in the head and call it a day. The end.
Yeah, we're done, right? That means I can go back to playing Skyrim. I can level up my Nord. And even then, I'll stop being a motherfucking casual!
Oh yeah, and this guy has one last thing to say before I go ahead and finish up the series.
If you like this video, don't forget to rate, comment, and subscribe, check out my other videos!
No.